Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm rendering exposition of Romans 11, verse 1 to 24, the remnant of Israel. Remember that the people of Israel, chosen people, they were people of the book. They were reading Torah, but not understanding. So that's why the remnant means that there will be very few among them who will understand gospel. Whereas the Gentiles, Samaritans, their ears were open. So they had gospel in abundance. But as these Israeli Jews, they hate Samaritans. So they always try to put their Torah in front and praise it. And then gave a bad name to the Samaritans or the Gentile. So they are still hypocrite. I ask, then has God rejected his people? That means is the chosen people. By no means, no. For I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham. That means he is forefather Abraham. In the name of Abraham, John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water. He never baptized a woman or a Gentile. They did not need baptism. A member of the tribe of Benjamin, here he mentioned tribe, is Benjamin tribe. God has not rejected his people, whom he foreknew. So God has not rejected, because this thing is obtained where if you are predestined. So those who were new, you know, those people Jesus picked up, 12 laborers. They were known to our father, foreknown to our father. And that's why Jesus picked them up. Do you not know what the scripture says of Elijah? How he, Elijah was John the Baptist, was Elijah. How he appeals to God against Israel. That he appeals to God because this appeals to God is Yahweh God, not our Father, you know. So, appeal to Yahweh, demiurge God. And not God that is spirit, you know. Demiurge God. Because Elijah is a chief priest, high priest of demiurge God, Yahweh. Well, Christ Jesus is the royal high priest of our God Father, which is spirit. So this Lord, you know, is only Yahweh is the Lord. Not our Father, our God. Lord, they have killed your prophets. They have demolished your altars. And I alone am left. That means remnant. And they seek my life. So they were so, you know, stubborn that they killed the prophet. So, he said, I am left alone, they are even want to kill me. But what is God's reply to him? God is Yahweh, you know. I kept for myself 7,000 men who have not bowed the knee to Baal. So too, at the present time, there is a remnant chosen by grace. So that is the Yahweh God speaking, and now the grace is of our Father. But if it is by grace, it is no longer on the basis of works. Remember what Saul was doing, works. They were not worth the praise. But he was doing it with great faith, what he had been told, and great reverence to God. So that is, nobody can utter his name and this and that, you know, can't write his name. That's all reverence. Otherwise, grace would no longer be grace. So the works, you know, if you are getting the thing by, if you do works, then you have been rewarded according to the works. Then you will forget about grace. Saul, he was torturing the laborers of Jesus. So his works were very much bad. They were not fit. But Father had grace. Father had grace on him, and with grace he was given the Holy Spirit with capital S, the very Spirit of God that made him the twin brother of Christ Jesus. What then? Israel failed to obtain what it was seeking. If without, you know, if you don't submit yourself, then you don't get it. The elect obtained it, but the rest was hardened, as it is written. Elect means those who are predestined, and Jesus picked them up, and they gained it. The rest of the Judah tribe people, their hearts were hardened. They killed Jesus, killed Stephen, and all that apostles, as it is written. God gave them a spirit of stupor. Stupor, stupor could be a stupid animal like donkey. Donkey, you know, stupor. Eyes that would not see. That means eyes, is these two eyes, then your third eye of logical reasoning. That eye could not see, perceive, and ears that would not hear, because their mind is not awakened, down to this very day. And David says, let their table become a snare and a trap, a stumbling block, and a retribution for them. So David says that let their table become a snare, that they eat, you know, and they get all these things by hook or by crook, and that becomes snare. Let their eyes be darkened so that they cannot see, and bend their backs forever, so they won't honor the Christ. Gentile grafted in. So I ask, did they stumble in order that they might fall? By no means. Rather, through their trespass, salvation has come to the Gentiles. So the Gentiles, you know, they have obeyed the will of our Father, and they got the reward, whereas the Jews, chosen people, they did not. They were arrogant of their Torah. So they did not get anything except those who were predestined. So as to make Israel jealous. So then when the Samaritan man get all these spiritual power, then the chosen people say, we were supposed to be having it, the favors of our father, but why this man is having? So they become jealous of the Gentile. They hate them because they think they are stupid. But when they Gentile get the Holy Spirit, then these chosen people are jealous. You know, why he got it? Now, if their trespass means riches for the world, and if their failure means riches for the Gentile, if their trespass means riches for the world, riches for the world is that these chosen people, they are demonstration nation of the world. We call them the nation of priest. Priest mean giving secular education, body education, not spiritual. So they are nation of priests. Through demonstration, they teach people the will of our Father. For example, the Jews, they are unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh. So when they are unfaithful to Abraham, they were thrown out of the promised land, because that belongs only to faithful sons of Abraham. And when they are trespass riches, when they make so many trespass means riches for the world, that through their mistakes or through their sins, the people of the world know the right path. And if their failure means riches for the Gentile, how much more will their full inclusion means? The Gentile, which they call them Goshikopa, stupid people, if they get the from God is blessing them with that riches, then how much riches the Jews will have there, which are his chosen people. Now I'm speaking to you Gentiles, in as much then as I am an apostle to the Gentiles. I magnify my ministry in order somehow to make my fellow Jews jealous and thus save some of them. So jealous means to shake them, to waken them up. Wake up, you know, look, Gentile are getting the royal kingdom of God. Why not you? So Gentile were the people. Remember the parable of the marriage of the son? So father sends his messenger, go and call my people. The Jewish people did not turn up. They gave one excuse or the other. Then father sends them, go stand at the corners, bring anyone. Then the Gentile came in great number and filled the hall. When father came, he found one man not properly dressed, and that was Judas Iscariot, that Jesus threw at the Last Supper. So you can see how make them jealous, you know, that they have come so many in number and we are few. For if their rejection means the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance mean but life from the dead? So if, you know, the Jewish people, they rejected the Gentile, and that is life to the world. Because Gentile, by preaching gospel, they reconciled the world, made them together. What will the acceptance means but life from the dead? Dead because they were dead in letters. So if the chosen people accept it, then they will get life. If the dove offered as first fruits is holy, so is the whole lump. And if the root is holy, so are the branches. Simple. If the evil tree will not bear good fruit, and a good holy tree will never bear a bad fruit. So that's what is here. But if some of the branches were broken off, and you, although a wild olive shoot, were grafted in among the others, and now share in the nourishing root of the olive tree. So a branch is giving a good example that if an olive tree had some branches, and some of these branches, you know, they listen to the word of God, but they reject it, as Judas Iscariot did. So Judas Iscariot was sitting at the outside the gate of our Father's vineyard, where the true vine Christ Jesus is planted. I had some table over there. Where true vine is planted. So they are not daring to go inside because they are frightened. They love mammon more than God, as Judas Iscariot did. So wild olive shoots. Wild olive shoots are Gentile, which are, you know, the Jewish people think they are stupid people. So if they are they get grafted to the true vine and now share in the nourishing root of the olive tree. So now they get the nourishing root. Root, you know, the root of the foods supply the food. Root is his word. Do not be arrogant towards the branches. So you don't be arrogant, you know, you don't be jealous that these branches are greener and we have withered away. The Jewish people, when their mind is open, or they are open, their mind can understand, is not sleeping, is awake. They will try to do business to make money and not spend it, the same mind, to earn his treasures. If you are remember, it is not you who sport the root, but the root that sports you. So, if you remember that you are a branch there, grafted yourself, then it's not you. You are remembered, it is not you who sport the root. So it's not you, you know, that sport the root, you know, his word. Gospel is hidden like roots, but the root that supports you. So that root is supporting you. Then you will say, branches were broken off so that I might be grafted in. So you will say, you know, that, oh, let some of these branches come off so I have my place over there to be grafted, but that chance is missing. Because you were given the chance, Christ Jesus came among you, and you did not listen to him. You rather killed him. So you won't be given the second chance. That is true. They were broken off because of their unbelief. The Jewish people, they were not believing, but the Gentile believed. Remember this at the Samaritan village, the Samaritan woman at the well, she was so spiritually advanced that she identified Jesus to be a prophet. And her five husbands, they were spiritual, not physical. They were calm. Calm means sex. Then krodh, anger, lobh, greed, moh, worldly attraction, and hankar, haughtiness. So these five husbands, she had overpowered, because her knowledge was very great and she was a practical woman. She was Saint Fortina, but these Jewish people, they hate them. So they painted a bad black picture. That is true. They were broken off because of their unbelief, but you stand fast through faith. So do not become proud, but fear. You know, if you become proud, you know, like Jewish people are proud of the shawl and all that they put on and sit in the synagogue, and they go very proudly that we are Jews. The other people are not Jews. But fear. For if God did not spare the natural branches, that means natural branches which were with him, natural man, if he misbehave, you know, then God doesn't spare him. So he doesn't give him the royal kingdom of God. Neither will he spare you. So he won't spare you, you know, because you are adopted branches. So the natural branch, natural one are chosen people. Note then the kindness and severity of God, severity towards those who have fallen, but God's kindness to you, provided you continue in his kindness. Otherwise, you too will be cut off, and even they, if they do not continue in their unbelief, will be grafted in. For God has the power to graft them in again. So that means if you repent, you know, or you come, you don't believe it, then you believe it, then you are welcome. For if you were cut from what is by nature a wild olive tree, and grafted, contrary to nature, into a cultivated olive tree. That means twice born person. Natural means once born person. How much more will these, the natural branches, be grafted back into their own olive tree? So, they can, natural branches, they can go to their natural, mean the natural, which olive tree, which is of God. Remember the story of the vineyard of our father, where he planted Christ Jesus, the true vine. And our aim is to get ourselves grafted to that true vine by entering through the narrow gate. And there is a kiln of his fire, of his word, and which you have to bear. Our Father God blesses you.